Welcome back. I'm still Taylor, and let's keep exploring the world of biology. So far, we've unpacked that cells are the basic unit of all life, and that all cells contain a protective plasma membrane, identifying DNA, a jelly cytoplasm, and builder ribosomes. But we also know that there are lots of different cells in our universe. What makes a cell different? Our jumping off question for today is, what types of cells exist? In this lesson, our goals are to understand cell types and what differentiates those types of cells. If you're following along with your guided notes, pause the video now to jot down what types of cells you think or know exist. Tons and tons of different specialized and specific cells exist. To begin to understand these differences between cells, we'll start with the two broadest categories of cells, prokaryotic and eukaryotic cells. We know that all cells contain DNA, but a eukaryotic cell neatly stores its DNA linearly in a nucleus, dyed dark pink in this under the microscope image. The nucleus has a protective plasma membrane, just like the plasma membrane around the entire cell, to keep the DNA safe. Another key feature of eukaryotic cells is that they contain several other different membrane-bound organelles, like the nucleus. Many of the specialized bits, aka organelles, inside eukaryotic cells are encased in plasma membranes, again, just like the plasma membrane around the entire cell, to protect that organelle and its function. Another super important membrane-bound organelle in eukaryotic cells is the mitochondria. Through lots of chemical reactions, this organelle generates all the chemical energy that the cell needs to function. Most eukaryotic cells contain lots of mitochondria because cells need lots of energy to function. Most organisms with eukaryotic cells are multicellular, meaning each organism is built of more than one, usually a lot more than one, eukaryotic cell. For example, us humans are multicellular eukaryotic organisms, and we are each made up of a lot more than one eukaryotic cell. It's estimated that an average adult human is built of around 37 trillion cells. All animals, plants, and fungi, like mushrooms and yeast, are multicellular eukaryotes. Each and every plant, animal, and fungus that we've encountered so far are built out of many cells that contain nuclei, mitochondria, other membrane-bound organelles, and of course, DNA and ribosomes, all floating in the cytoplasm, all surrounded by the cell membrane. Within each of these organisms, all of the cells have to work together as a cohesive system. In us humans, this cat, and in many other organisms, specialized cells work together to form different tissues, which together form different organs, which are then organized into organ systems. For example, this cat's brain and spinal cord are each made of tons of cells and work together to form our central nervous system. Let's go deeper to explore the differences between plant, animal, and fungal cells. Plant cells have a rigid cell wall around their cell membrane, providing both structure and further protection from the outside world. Some fungal cells have a different type of cell wall, while animal cells don't have any sort of cell wall. Both fungi and animals take in nutrients by eating, in different ways. Plants, on the other hand, create the nutrients they need through a sun-fueled process called photosynthesis. In a future lesson, we'll dive deeper into photosynthesis, but for now, we'll consider the membrane-bound organelle in plant cells that allows them to photosynthesize, chloroplasts. Animal and fungal cells don't contain chloroplasts because they don't need them. Let's transition from eukaryotic to prokaryotic cells. Prokaryotic cells are both less complicated and smaller than eukaryotic cells. Prokaryotic cells don't contain any membrane-bound organelles, which means no nucleus or mitochondria. Without a nucleus, prokaryotic DNA is circular and floats freely in the cytoplasm of the cell. prokaryotic cells are usually around 1 to 5 micrometers long, while eukaryotic cells range from around 10 to 100 micrometers long. All prokaryotes are unicellular organisms, meaning each organism is just one prokaryotic cell. All bacteria, like E. coli and Salmonella, and archaea, microscopic organisms similar but genetically different from bacteria, are each made of just one prokaryotic cell. In this image, each of these rod-shaped cells is a separate bacteria organism. For bacteria and archaea, their entire system is just one cell, making the organism far, far less complex than multicellular eukaryotes. Some of these organisms can form large colonies to support each other, but each cell is still a distinct organism with its own particular DNA. At this point, you may think that all organisms with eukaryotic cells are multicellular, and all organisms with a prokaryotic cell are unicellular. But the former isn't quite true. Some organisms are just one eukaryotic cell. These organisms are chromista, including algae, and protists, including molds. Most eukaryotes are multicellular, but it's important to know that these unicellular eukaryotes also exist. Throughout this lesson, we've explored different types of cells, but we haven't looked at a lot of microscope images of cells. We've looked at models of these cells. A scientific model is a simplification of a real phenomenon to clearly explain it. A scientific model can be a drawing or a diagram, like the ones we've used today, 3D representation, a computer simulation, mathematical representation or description, or even an analogy. The virtual light and electron microscopes from previous lessons are both models too. By their very nature, scientific models have limitations, but are still extremely useful for explaining and predicting, and are modified as further evidence is discovered. As we wrap up this lesson, did we learn what we aim to learn? Pause this video and try to complete this Venn diagram in a notebook or in your guided notes. Prokaryotic and eukaryotic cells both have the bits that unite all cells: DNA, a plasma cell membrane, a cytoplasm, and ribosomes. You could have also indicated that they're both, of course, cells. The final similarity is that all prokaryotes and some eukaryotes are unicellular organisms. A eukaryotic cell is distinguished by a membrane-bound nucleus that holds its DNA, a membrane-bound mitochondria that produces the cell's chemical energy, and other membrane-bound organelles. You could have also indicated that eukaryotic cells are usually 10 to 100 micrometers, eukaryotic DNA is linear, and most but not all eukaryotes are multicellular, including all animals, plants, and fungi. Prokaryotic cells don't have any membrane-bound organelles. Their DNA is circular and just freely floats in the cytoplasm. Prokaryotic cells are smaller than eukaryotic cells at 1 to 5 micrometers, and all prokaryotes are unicellular, including all bacteria and archaea. Score! Way to learn stuff. Now, go refine and test your understanding of these fundamental cell biology concepts with the practice questions and PDF. In the PDF, you'll even develop your own cell model. And coming up, we'll dive deeper into animal and plant cells. Hey, hey.